Tell me three things that you love about Uncle John.
Car.
He's got a car. What else?
Dinosaur.
He's got dinosaurs. And what else?
A sheep.
A sheep.
And he's got a sheep.
Okay, one, that he's kind.
Mm-hmm.
Two, that he makes you happy. Char, you happy? And three, he is brilliant with Violet and Ralph.
Big.
Friendly.
Drunk.
Bear. Because he's a big, friendly, drunk bear.
Absolutely that.
I think John is very witty and always makes me laugh.
I think John is like a brother. He's a very caring and sensitive guy and very thoughtful.
John is so nice. John is so caring. John is so awesome. What a load of bollocks. Hello, I'm Matt, and I'm this man's best man. Best man I can find. When I said I was going to make John a video, people were concerned it would just be 5 minutes of various people calling John a wanker. The video is actually 15 minutes long, but don't worry, there is no wanker here at all. There is no wanker in this video whatsoever. Nobody calls anybody a wanker. There probably won't be any swearing in it. Probably, what do I know? I am only putting together videos that you have sent me, so it's on you. I have been careful that this may not be entirely child friendly, so if you're sensitive about what your kids see, you may just want to ease them out of the door now. For any children left, congratulations, your parents are cool. Now, what many of you know we've done here is you've all sent me videos and I have put them together to try and encapsulate John. John in a 15 minute video. It's a few stories, some of which you may know, some of which you probably haven't heard. There was one his parents told me that will haunt me to my grave. And I hope everyone enjoys it. So let's start our story now. And as all good stories should start, this one begins with the conception of our protagonist. Best man I can. How was John conceived? Would you describe it as a hate crime?
No.
No, I suppose not.
We really wanted a second child.
Yeah.
And the time was right. It was the right time of the month. So we did the deed.
No!
And the next morning I just knew I was pregnant.
Woohoo! Would you have described the birth as traumatic?
It was quite eventful, with Alan and the nurse who was looking after me rolling around on the floor telling jokes. Meanwhile, John just popped out. John was known as Joan for the first 48 hours until the doctors discovered his micropenis.
Despite this tiny setback, John had an exciting childhood full of wonder and joy. I asked his brother Paul to give me his thoughts on having such a wonderful brother.
I've known John for the last 38 years on account of being his brother, and he's only managed to piss me off for the last 36. Of course, the first two he spent dribbling and pissing his pants, but then nothing ever changes, does it?
Between these prolonged bouts of dribbling and pissing his pants, John loved watching movies and dreamt of being like his big screen idols, a New York City cop who dies hard, a Top Gun maverick fighter pilot, the Silence of the Lambs cross-dressing serial killer. Despite being simple, John dreamed big. The stories from people who knew him as a child certainly sound like scenes from a horror film.
I met John at secondary school. We were both quite geeky and got on really, really well, apart from the time that we had a bit of an argument and he nearly threw me over a glass balcony, and I got him into trouble for it. But apart from that, we got on quite well.
John, do you remember the time you were about two, maybe, and you came into the living room? You'd been to the toilet, and I'd been doing some sewing, and we discovered that you'd put a pin up your butt.
Oh.
visions of having to take you to the doctor's to get it removed, but I took it out myself.
That's why he's now called Pencil Dick.
Now, I have one or two stories I could tell you about John, as you could imagine. I could tell you about the time John frantically called me up in tears because his £1,200 imported American sit-on anal probe blew up as he plugged a 110-volt power supply unit directly into a British 210-volt power socket. It never worked again, but he loved those 5 seconds of direct anal electrical stimulation. But my favourite John story ever is the McChicken story. Now, John and I used to eat in Burger King most days. One day I told him I'd seen a TV advert saying that, as Burger King were trying to beat McDonald's, if you went up to the Burger King cashier and screamed, "McChicken!" they would give you a free Burger King version of the chicken burger. Now, excited at this prospect, John, beaming, walks up to the young, unsuspecting lady at the Burger King till and screams at her as loud as he can, "McChicken!" The whole place went silent, babies started crying, and then people started laughing. It was brilliant. Now, John will say that this McChicken story isn't true, but you tell me what is more believable. That John went into a Burger King and screamed, "McChicken!" at a terrified cashier, or John risked the chance to miss out on free food. So, what do John's new friends think of him?
Yeah, John's a Wally.
I'm a monster!
Is that what you like about Uncle John?
Word I would use to describe John is wasted.
Affectionate.
About the word that sums up John, as far as I'm concerned, is non-utilitarian.
Kinky.
Exasperating.
So I'm going to start off with ridiculously.
Random. And it's because John always comes out with a fact for everything.
Fun John fact. John has an IQ of 122. Which, statistically speaking, means he is smarter than 91.1% of people in this room. That means he is probably smarter than you. Now I know a question that many of you in this room are wondering is, as John is officially...
ginormous!
Is that a reflection on his sexual prowess? His parents say no.
Pencil dick.
But let's ask other people in this room what they have heard or tasted themselves.
Tiny.
John's got a teeny tiny penis.
Okay.
That has got to be the smallest dick I have ever seen in my whole life. Get the fuck out of here. Eeny weeny, teeny weeny, shriveled little short dick man. Don't want. Eeny weeny, teeny weeny, shriveled little short dick man. Don't want.
Tiny.
Don't want no short dick man.
Does it even touch the molars?
I know I meant to embarrass John here by discussing his ex-girlfriends, but if you've all seen him, you'll not be surprised to know there's not a lot to say. I could tell you about John's dogging days with the 85-year-old couple cheering him on, or how John's early dating life dovetailed well with his yeti hunting obsession, as he liked them big and hairy. How he then progressed onto internet dating and Grindr, which kept him busy and sore for a few years. But these are things of the past, and now we should be looking forward. Now he is clearly a changed man, and John is very much in love, and not just with himself for once. Sure, he never did get to follow his boyhood dreams of being a New York City diehard cop, a Top Gun fighter pilot, or a cross-dressing serial killer, but his love for films did lead him to a brief film career before making less mainstream movies. These days, John is happy just to cuddle up and watch a film,
particularly if it stars a teenage boy. This new age John, the mature John, he's got winner stamped all over his head. He is a genuinely nice guy. He would do anything for or to anyone. He's always there to help out when needed. So let's go back once again and listen to what his friends said about him. And this time, let's really listen to what they are saying.
Word I would use to describe John is wasted.
Affectionate.
Non-utilitarian.
Kinky.
Exasperating.
Random.
So think, John. Think W-A-N-K-E-R. And those letters again. W-A-N-K-E-R. And that, ladies and gentlemen, sums up John perfectly.
I'm a wanker, and it does me good like it bloody well should. I'm a wanker, and I'm always pulling my hood. I was 25.
Word to describe John beginning with S. Sexy.
Chatty.
And simple. He's a little bit simple. Emma, what would you say?
Can you let go of my arm? Thanks. I'm going to go with sarcastic and sassy. Very sassy. What about you, Ralph? What do you think? Simple, sexy, or sassy?
Sassy.
Very sassy.
Finally, and this is a difficult one because we've been asked to say something nice about John. Beth, I'm stumped here. Can you start us off?
John, thank you for introducing me to the Trump cocktail in Worthing. I'm still holding to you to the fact that you've got to get me one of those mugs.
And I guess, John, okay, well, I guess thank you very much for making me feel like it's okay with the amount of gin I drink, because I can always count on you to drink more. Charlotte, on a serious note, you've done well. You two are fantastic, and I'm sure you look great right now. So, well done, and John, we love you.
Love you, John.
Yeah, he's all right.
The word I would use to describe John, unforgettable.
Word I would use to describe John, Marmite.
Word I would use to describe John, aardvark.
And that just about wraps things up. I hope everybody enjoyed it. Especially you, John. I can tell by the audience reaction it must have gone down a storm. I didn't want this video to end on that wanker song, even though it's very catchy and, you know, it may remind you of somebody. So, congratulations, John. Let's do the traditional best manny bit here when I say thank you to various people. You out there, the bride's people. Thank you to the ushery people. I don't know who's coming. I mean, let's be honest, most of you didn't know John 2 years ago anyway, did you? Let's be honest. So let's have a toast to the bride and the groom. Congratulations. We wish you the best. And now we're going to do a Lord of the Rings fake ending by having two more videos just to end with, one of which is a very special man who had a very special boy who's very special, and the other one is, let's be honest, another special message for a special boy from a special boy's bride. Hope you've enjoyed this all. Thank you for being patient, and get this man some more drinks. Bye!
John, I'm very proud of you and all you've done in your life. Keep up the good work. Your dad.
Past 9 o'clock. This is John.
John. You all right?
Yeah. This is it. This is my life for the next...
Secrecy.
What, like, a
year? What are you two doing here? Soon you'll be baking, that's why.
Does it look like my bacon needs saving?
He's lucky.
He's a wanker, he's a wanker, and it does seem good like it bloody well should. He's a wanker, and he's always pulling his butt. He's a wanker, and it does seem good like it bloody well should. He's a wanker, he's a wanker.